Hi. So this is the word of the day, layer, LAYER, all small. So please mark your attendance. The word is layer, LAYER, all small. I hope everyone has noted down. Please mark your attendance accordingly. I'll move ahead to the next session. If someone has missed, then they can refer the recording of this session. It will be available for them to look at the word and post their attendance. Thank you. Okay. So now we'll quickly have a look at two of the new views which are introduced in version 2.34 and above, the split view and the timeline maps. So basically, when you are dealing with your relative periods, you're able to split the periods into an individual view for each of these periods. So in this split view, you're able to see the data individually for each relative period which you have selected in your period when you were creating your map. Okay. So through this view, you're able to see the data for each of the month. So in May 2020, this was the coverage of BCG for the set of districts in training land. In June 2020, this was the coverage. You could see there is a value which is in the invalid range, which is greater than 100%. So this could be looked into to just check the quality of data which has been reported. So you could create these split view charts and they can also be added on the dashboard. So let's quickly see how we can create a chart with split view. So I'll just refresh the canvas once and I'll click on add layer, select thematic layer, I'll select my indicator, I'd say BCG coverage. Okay, I'll go to my period relative, I'll just select last 6 months. Okay, and then when you select your relative periods, you see that there are options available to select the display periods. Okay, so single aggregate we just saw, it shows you the thematic layer as it is for one specific view. So you have a single view, then you have timeline, and then you have split map views. Okay, the split map view shows you individual view for the periods which you have selected. So I'll just select split map views here. Okay, I'll go to org units, I'll select training land, click on district and remove region. Okay, and since I have already selected my BCG coverage that has a pre-assigned legend for EPI coverage, so that gets automatically selected. Okay, so I'll just check my settings again. So I selected BCG coverage, period last 6 months, as a split map use, or given it's at the district levels, and no changes on the filter and the style. And I click on add layer. Okay. So since I had selected last 6 months, so I should get 6 views, one for each month, which becomes part of my last 6 months relative period. Okay. So this is how you can create your split view map where you can get individual information for each month. Okay. Okay. Now you can also convert this view into a timeline view. Okay, so now what you see here is individual snapshot of each month for which I had created this map. But then there is also another way of showing this particular data is in form of timeline, which is kind of a sort of a video presentation where you kind of see the timeline moving and the changes in data happening over that timeline through the timeline view. Okay, so for using the timeline view, you select timeline here and you can update your layer. So this will convert the split view into a timeline view, and you see a play button below. So when you click on that button, it will start moving from one month to another, and it can kind of show you how the data was transformed from beginning from November of 2020 to April of 2021. Okay, so you can play this again if you want to. You can add this on the dashboard. On the dashboard also you get display functions, so you can see how the data has progressed in the last 6 months for the BCG coverage, and then you can compare things accordingly. Okay, so this is how we can use the split view and the timeline view when you're creating a map, preferably for the relative periods, because you have multiple periods which will get updated over time, so it's better to use relative periods there. Okay, then the last thing that I wanted to cover was the bubble maps. So for example, with this COVID pandemic, there were a lot of use cases coming where different types of visualizations were used to show on maps, and bubble maps was one of them, which were kind of showing you the proportionate number of cases coming from each geographic locations, and based on the proportion, it was showing the increase or decrease in the size of the caseload. Okay, through that respective bubble. Okay, so let's try to open an existing favorite from the bubble map. So okay, so let me look for the example which I was trying to do. Yeah. So here you see that there are different bubbles available here, and the size of the bubble is proportionate to the cases which have been reported. Okay. So in this way, you can plot wherever you want to have similar cases, you want to plot the caseload for specific diseases. Then you could, this is an example, of course, you can apply to different use cases as well. And then you could see that the number of cases or the data volume reported is kind of proportional to the size of the bubble which you see. So now if you see the selections which we made here were, it is identical to how we have been using them, the selections before for data. So we selected our indicator, the period as this year, org units at the district level. There was no filter needed, but the style was changed to the bubble map. Okay, so had been a choropleth map, if I change this, then you see that it kind of shows you the volume of cases as a flat distribution across district. So there are no proportion involved here. Okay, you can only see by the color that which are the districts which have high caseload, which are the districts which have low caseload. But if you change this to a bubble map, then it kind of gives you a more proportionate way of showing the data in terms of both the color gradient as well as the size of the bubble, to kind of make you easily see that what are the districts which are contributing to a higher malaria caseload and what are the districts which are contributing to a lower malaria caseload. Okay, so this is another way where you could utilize the data from a conventional heat map, but using a bubble map to see the proportionate set of information. Okay, so this was the last two exercises that we left. One was to look at the split and the timeline view, and the other was to create a bubble map. So let's quickly take 10 minutes and review those exercises, and then we can take the final questions and close to this session then.